The junior and our new team classmates have also provided some special prepare our minds and our hearts as we enter into the next hour of worship service.
Make sure you read the bulletin, and if by chance you got a bulletin that is marked the 29th, and we would like on to the 22nd, just raise your hand, and if we have some people, they call them. Can you grab a couple of bulletins? Because we got some new stuff. Some of you got 29 instead of 27. And if you came in this morning, we'd like to thank Aaron Mann and George Anderson for their playing out in the foyers. I just raised up your hands if there's anyone on the crowd for 29 instead of 27. And we'd like to thank him for the day of coming. It was very beautiful. We'd like to thank the Dean family for having hot chocolate and cookies. And it was very warm and welcoming way coming to the church. And they are going to be filing the floors on December 27th and 28th. They're stripping them and waxing them. So we ask if you happen to come into the building at that time, you would stay off the area that the roof is being run out. And then we have the ACS Center. He is going to be closed on December 24th. The Vegetarian Supper Club is the 6th of January. And which has been a real blessing and really made very good work, and hats off to the women that are taking the time to do this. And on January 9th through the 19th, we are doing the 10 days of prayer, and so keep that in mind. And on the 19th, Westwood Pine Park Derby. And they're going to be racing on the round track this year. But I've heard it's going to be very good. And then also remember about the Cooking University that is on the 25th of December. And we also have prayer bands meeting here after the worship service. So we just ask if you can go on to the foyer to do your research. And now at this time, I'm going to pass.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm glad to see you're here. The minds were wrong. Aren't you glad of that? I'm glad they were wrong and the Bible was right. Hey, there was no doubt in my mind. In your hands, for the members of the West County Church, you have the final draft of the nominating report. If you have not yet, take time to cruise through it. And so this is the final draft. This is the second reading. And I recall from the floor, is there a nomination to accept the nominating committee's report at this time? There's a motion, there's a second. Those in favor, raise your hand. Is there any opposed? Okay, so moved. So at this time, this is the new offices for 2013 to 2015. At this time, our church service will begin as we invite our summer leaders.
Thank you.
This morning we come to you with open hearts. We come to you with open minds. We invite you into our hearts. We invite you, Lord, into this congregation. We lift up our voices in praise. And we ask, Lord, that you accept our worship. Lord, it's this time of year that we can reflect back on that amazing, amazing gift that you brought down from heaven through your Son, Jesus Christ. And Lord, may we reflect on that this day. And may we worship the one who made propitiation for our sins. In your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Let us stay standing as we sing our opening hymn, number 119, Angels from the Realms of Glory. Hymn number 119.
We thank you, Father, you allow the Son you allow their brain to fall upon the righteous and the wicked alike. Your mercy endures forever. Your kindness, Lord, is everlasting. And Lord, we know it is a victim, yet you offer it to us. Even in our righteousness, Lord, it's a filthy rags. And yet in abundance you have given us. And through your grace you have sent your Son. And through your mercy you have redeemed us. And so, Father, we thank you for the wonderful gifts of life that you have given us. We thank you for the wonderful gift of family that you have given us and bringing us together even this day, in this morning. The gift of brothers and sisters coming together and aunts and uncles and grandchildren that haven't seen grandparents in a while. We're so thankful, Lord, that there is a uniting of families today. And more so, a great uniting of families that will happen one day in heaven. And so, Lord, we ask that you continue to do the work in our hearts that needs to be done. We also ask for the work that needs to be done in the financial areas of our life, as well as the spiritual areas. We ask for the work of the physical areas of our life that needs to be worked upon. Those that are sick with the flu and other sicknesses, you know that what we are struggling with, Lord, and we are in need of a great physician. I think of our brothers and sisters and family members that are across the seas and around the world in our military that are going to be away from family this season, this holiday, as they reflect upon the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that you might draw near to them. Protect them and bring them, Lord, home the day that you appointed. And Lord, I pray that in our service today, your Holy Spirit will be here in the most powerful way. As we lift up our voices, as we give in our offering, as we give of ourselves, Lord, may you accept our worship in Jesus' name. Amen.
draw this one according to my husband's faith. I didn't do a good job. Alright. But there was a man with his faith. But look at his faith. What is it? The eyes, the nose, and the mouth, and the eyebrows, teeth, okay. Children laughing, I can hear people singing, I can hear the birds. knees and sun came up, like upside down, okay? And the sun scorched, okay? It got so hot, the man started sweating. And his sweat came down on his face. Guess where he went to first? His eyes. And then, it's not working really good. And you know what I said? Oh no, what's this? My eyes sting! I cannot see! And then he started crying. So the tears came down. And when you cry, the tears only don't come down this way, but it goes inside too. Guess where they go to? Their nose, okay? And then, what does your nose do? So, the snot started coming out.
Okay?
When you go home, please ask your companion to read for you, okay? have future. Okay? So let us do our best according to what God has given us to do. Okay? You can go back in.
His name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us. The light of the knowledge of the glory of God is seen in the face of Jesus Christ. From the days of eternity, the Lord Jesus Christ was one with the Father. He was the image of God, the image of his greatness and majesty, the outshining of his glory. It was to manifest this glory that he came to our world. To this sin-darkened earth, he came to reveal the light of God's love, to be God with us. Therefore, it was prophesied of him, his name shall be called Emmanuel.
Thank you.
to the eastern extremity of the town, vainly seeking a resting place for Zion. There is no room for them at the crowded inn. In a rude building where the beasts are sheltered, they at last find refuge. And here, the Redeemer of the world is born.
Thank you.
Deliverer has come to Israel. Power, exaltation, triumph are associated with his coming. But the angel must prepare them to recognize their Savior in poverty and humiliation. This shall be a sign unto you, he says. Ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Thank you.
beginning. The whole plain was lit with the broad shining of the host of God. Earth was hushed, and heaven stooped to listen to the song, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Would you pray with me? Precious Father in heaven, thank you. It's a blessing to be in your house today. I'm blessed by the music that is sung to lift up your Son, Jesus Christ. And I thank you, Father, for the solution that you have for us. And I pray, Lord, that each one of us could take advantage of the solution. In your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
God has a permanent solution to sin problem. For unto us a child is born, a child of flesh, Jesus' humanity. Unto us a son is given, the Son of God, Jesus' divinity. The best way that we can understand the true meaning of Christmas is that Christmas is the intervention of God on a world that has gone amok. Can you say amen to that? And we are all in the mix of it. Our passage this morning in Isaiah chapter 9. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. If you'd like to turn there. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Our passage this morning was taken from the writings of the prophet Isaiah. And in his writings, he often spoke of Jesus. In his writings, he often spoke of Jesus. And these writings are set over 400 years written before Jesus was even born. Amazing. These words were written in antiquity. And in them we find Jesus called by many names. And the first one, he's called Wonderful. The words are translated in the Hebrew denotes something that is incredibly great. Something that is so tremendous that it is literally beyond description. Something that is beyond the abstract. Something that is beyond comprehension, at least in human minds and terms. You remember, some of you, what you were doing on July of 1969? I was just about this big. July 21st, in fact, 1969, President Nixon said that the greatest event in human history is that man set foot on the moon. But the greatest event in human history was when God stepped out of heaven and became man. The greatest event that has ever happened, we call it the incarnation. That Almighty God stepped out of heaven and he came out of his ivory palace into a world of woe and he put his feet upon this earth. I would agree that to put man on the moon was a great task. But what good is it to put a man on the moon and not have God in our hearts? What good is it to know astronomy, the study of the stars, and not know the bright and morning star? What good is it to know botany, the study of flowers, and not know that Jesus, the heaven's sweet rose of sharing? What good is it to know history and not know Jesus and his story? For in him we live and we move and we have our being. What good is it to know geology, the study of rocks, and not know Jesus, the Rock of Ages? The greatest event was not man going to the moon, but God coming to the earth in the form of a baby. And so our message today is entitled, His Name is Wonderful. Jesus was wonderful in his birth. Isaiah says that a virgin will conceive. Isaiah's prophecy given here in Isaiah 7, verse 14, says it was one of a miraculous birth. But the wonderful aspects of Jesus' start with this prophecy. We see that in Gabriel's message to Mary in Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 38, we see that this wonderful and miraculous meeting, we see Mary's reaction between her encounter with Gabriel. We see that she is confused about what is about to happen, but she is given a reassuring answer by the angel. The virgin birth was a wonderful miracle, but it wasn't the only one that was to take place at the time of his birth. There was an angelic appearance besides the one to Mary. The fact that that she was able to make the trip to be taxed, and that she was able to, at the time of her birth, was a miracle. I wish I had time to show a short video of what she went through as she was in labor. Riding on that donkey was a miracle in itself. The greatest star, or the gathering of angels that hung in the heavens, was a miracle. The travels of the wise men that brought them to the Bethlehem was a miracle. And we can't try to explain these things, these wonders of Jesus' birth by science. We can't try to explain. Many have tried, and many have failed. By science, they try to explain the virgin birth. By science, they try to explain the star that shone in the heavens. I remember my 8th grade science class, and I remember the teacher talking about the possibility of a star being a supernova at that time. But little did that Jewish professor know about the angels that hung in the stars or in the sky that night. By science, they tried to explain the angelic visit. We know and we see that Jesus' birth was a great and wonderful event, and that Jesus is wonderful in his birth, but the story does not stop there. For the attribute of him being wonderful follows into the next step and the next point in his life, for we see that Jesus was also wonderful in his life. That wonderful infant that we find in the manger that we sing about was a miracle, but Jesus is no longer in the manger. The wonderful birth was only a small part of God's greater plan. We no longer worship the baby in the manger. We worship a sinless Savior who meets people where they are, who gives people hope. Jesus throughout his life and his ministry brought hope to the hopeless. The woman with the issue of blood, he brought hope. The blind man named Bartimaeus, the 10 lepers, the thief on the cross, and the countless others that he touched, he brought hope. He will meet you where you are in your crisis, and he will rescue you. He will shelter you from the wind, a safe harbor from the raging storm, a flowing river in the midst of the desert. He's like the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. And in the same today, he is doing it in your ministries. And he's doing it in his ministry. He will meet you in your crisis, and he will deliver you. And all, my friends, we have to do is ask. Right where we are, right now. Jesus was wonderful in his birth. Jesus was wonderful in his life, meeting people's needs, giving them comfort, giving them hope. But even at the end of his life, that attribute did fade away, because we also see that Jesus was wonderful in his death. As we read scripture, then we see that all will die because of sin. It's very clear. But Jesus lived a sinless life, and he gave his life for sinners. And it was a horrible, it was a painful, it was a terrible, and it was a wonderful cross.
died to carry our sorrows. He died as our substitute. And he died as all our sins were laid upon him on that horrible, terrible, and wonderful day. Every year at Christmas time, when I see baby Jesus, as I see him, as I sat the other night at the Christmas play in that little manger, I can't help picturing him 33 years later, nailed to the cross of Calvary. I can't help seeing that. From the cradle to the cross, that was his destiny. He was born to die for us. You see, that's why Simeon prophesied to Mary that day that they presented Jesus at the temple. He said in Luke chapter 2, verse 35, he said, "Yes, a sword will pierce through your own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." Simeon was talking about that day when the blood of Jesus would be shed in my place and in your place, when that all the sins of the world would rest upon his broad shoulders. I don't know if we really understand the weight. We praise Jesus the Christ this Christmas season for taking the punishment for us. On that horrible day, Christ gave us his all. His attribute of being wonderful shone through like the sun shining through in the midst of a storm. But it doesn't end there for us. It didn't end at his death. It didn't end at the cross. Because I tell you today, Jesus is wonderful in his second coming as well. The one who was born to die for us, who lived a spotless ministry, who died wonderfully for us, who rose from the dead, will come again. His ascension into heaven, where he sits at the right hand of God, he now stands in the most holy place, judging the world. We are promised that he will come again. And that's the message, my brothers and sisters, my Sunday Adventist brothers and sisters, are to be sharing today with the people that's in your backyard, your neighbors, your brothers and sisters. We are promised that he will come again, and when he does, the dead of Christ will rise, and then we will all be caught up to meet him in the air. And when he comes again, the promise that was made so many years ago, that promise that was made to Mary, will be fulfilled. The words of the prophets will be fulfilled, that he will reign forever, and his kingdom will have no end. Amen? And in concluding this, if our greatest need would have been for information, God would have sent us an educator. Are you with me? If our greatest need would have been for technology, my friends, he would have sent us a scientist. If our greatest need would have been for money, he would have sent us an economist. And if our greatest need would have been for pleasure, he would have sent us an entertainer. But my friends, our greatest need was for forgiveness. So God sent us a Savior. Jesus is wonderful. And is Jesus wonderful to you? He can be. All we have to do is ask. If you desire to trust him, you can make him Lord of your life. And you will find that you can make him wonderful too. Amen. At this time, I want to invite our next musician forward to share with us.
closing candidates will come on the thing. And let us stand up and sing this holy gospel.
To show us the reason to live.
Edie and I received a call to go to Minnesota. It was not an easy decision to make. We will be pastoring one church in Minnesota. With the struggle of our health, we decided to accept the call and to take it. We will begin pastoring up in Minneapolis in the beginning of February. I did want to let the church know. Let's bow our heads and ask blessings. Gracious Father, we are thankful for this time of the year. I'm thankful that we can come together as a family and celebrate your Son, Jesus Christ. That we can come together and remember the wonderful time that Jesus, his birth, had meant to so many. Not only to the shepherd and the wise men, and to the peasants that had gathered around on that day, but to the countless ages, down to the centuries, who remember this time. Because of what it means to us in our hearts today, that a Savior has come. Lord, may you live in our hearts, just not during this season, but all year round. And that it might just permeate from us, that others may know you because you live within us. Bless us as we leave this place, and may we make an impact on the world.